Hey there, and welcome to Dull Motion. Oh, I can finally make my favorite Deus character, Morfeo Vulpes. For those who are new to the channel, Morfeo is a character from my stop motion series, Divus. Yes, the same fox from the logo. He's an ancestor to many of the main characters in the story. Morfeo is based on a shape-shifting kitsune from Japanese folklore. These yokai were known for their high intelligence and would grow extra tails when they reached a certain age. Depending on which old story you read, a kitsune could be either an evil or a good yokai to encounter. Some were even able to control fire. Kitsune make many cameos in popular media. Morfeo is mainly based on a kitsune, but also has traits from the European folklore stories, where the fox always outsmarts everyone. Well, with this in mind, let's make a nine-tailed fox Deus, Morfeo Vulpes. In my last repaint video, you were able to find a total of 6 hints. 1 for Morfeo, and 5 for the Felis siblings. Their repaint video is now available for supporters on Patreon and YouTube memberships. The video you are watching now will also contain a new written hint. So, good luck finding the hint. For this custom, we are going to use this Monster High Boy head and a Obitsu male body. In contrast with Deus Gorgon's snake hair, his flame hair was super easy to take off. I need to increase my doll ear collection, so these will also need to go. With pure acetone, we take off the factory painted face. Great! Let's work on his body. I like to give my original animal characters more animal features when they get older. But Morfeo is thousands of years old, so just like Emu, he will get more animal features than usual. But to give him that extra leg joint, we need to take them from this BTS doll. I found for just 2 euros. That's a very good deal. Definitely for a male doll. I'm going to take off his arm joints for Morfeo and his leg joints for a future Deus character. Wow, that doesn't look like a horror show at all. Well, let's round out the feet to make it more like a paw. Great, we got all our joints. But now for his wound or scar. Yes, in the Divus series, this fox character was killed by his friend Mortis and was brought back to life by his descendant James. And just like Emu, Morfeo will still have the wounds that kill him, a stab to the chest. Looking at the design I made for Morfeo, he has a red gradient on his arms, and these are also on his legs. To color the joints red, we're going to use red dimer. And now we can reconstruct the doll again by using sticks and glue. To fill in the gap, we use a 2-part epoxy sculpt. The next day we can sand it down for a smoother transition. And before I forget it, let's give Morfeo a large tail hole for his 9 future tails. Making a doll an overall white can be hard, but the trick is to use a primer first. So let's go outside and... Yeah, get a few bricks so your doll won't get blown away. Give it a few layers of primer and after that a few layers of white spray paint. Going back inside, we can paint the scar and give him some body blushing, giving him an overall cream color. And now for the gradients on his arms and legs. First, a layer of paint, and then multiple layers of pen pastels. I sprayed the arms and legs with varnish between every layer. Oh, and here's a tip for painting flexible doll hands. Mix Mod Podge with acrylic paint. This will prevent chipping. Okay, I got the original drawing next to me for reference. Let's sculpt his face and ears. The Monster High Boy left a big gap when we removed his flame hair, so I'm first going to close that. Then we make his way too pointy nose and big ears. The next day we can use his sanding block to make the transition from epoxy to vinyl head a bit more seamless. Time to match his head with his body color. To hide the paint brush strokes, we use a few layers of matte varnish. Now that's drying, let's work on his multiple tails and hair. To make the armature for the tails, I combined multiple wires for extra strength. After that, I covered all 9 tails with bandage tape. Whoa, we're going to use a lot of colors for Morpheo. Bind them to our giant fly swatter and comb out the yarn. The yarn that's meant for his hair will be straightened for a shiny and deeper look. But leave the rest of the yarn as it is. To make wefts, take a plastic bag and glue the yarn with fabric glue. Wow, I don't think I ever made so many wefts for a doll project. With a hot glue gun, I glue the yarn to the wires to make tails. And as you can see, I'm going for a gradient. To secure the tails, you really need to jam them in there. With multiple layers of super glue, these tails will stay in place forever. Okay, let's return to the face. We begin with the signature Vulpus Doze and Divis face markings. And some blushing. After a spray of Mrs. Super Clear, we can draw on the face. And yes, these need to be watercolor pencils. Oil-based pencils will smudge your face up. For Morpheus' face up, I was going a bit for a feminine look, making this character a bit androgynous. Morpheus is a shapeshifter and is half of the time a female character. And here we have the famous Family Fox green eyes. Now that I'm shading the eyes with pen pastels, let's answer the question of the day. Have you ever thought of memes for your characters? Well, not myself, but I did get a few memes from fans over the years. So let me show you a few of my favorites. Do you have a question of the day? Please leave your question in the comment section. And maybe I'll pick your question for the next repaint video. Back to the face-up. When you're happy with your face-up, give the doll's face a few layers of Mr. Super Clear. Lucky enough, I'm a bit of a hoarder, and I still have some white flock left from a previous doll project. We're going to use it for his ears. First some fabric glue, and then we push on the flock. The next step will be his hair. With a strong universal glue, we glue on the wefts and then spiral to the top. But placing the wefts around the ears can be tricky. I like to go for a hairstyle without a part. For this, we use a lot of glue and one mega weft. Not forgetting the ears, they get some fluff. After a trim, we can correct the areas around his ears for a neater look. Pinning away his hair, we can glue on the eyebrows. Some hair styling and high gloss varnish on his nose, scar and lips. Let's continue with his outfit. Interesting story, I designed Morpheus' outfit about a year ago, when he had a small appearance in this book in a Divas episode. I'm going to use the same design with a few alternations and a different color scheme. And I really need to say this, I was very impressed by the fan art I got back then. Some people could figure out an image of Morpheus from just this small cameo. Well, I don't really have a pattern for the outfit I want to make for Morpheus, so I basically made everything from scratch. Like this poofy pants. The pants will be held in place with some scratch fabric. It almost gives him a game character vibe. He also gets two shirts, both with gold detail. But one will cut a hole to reveal the scar on his chest. And with red ink, you can make everything bloody. This leftover red fabric can close above his tail and on the front, so it can rest on his hips. But for some extra detail, we're going to burn the edges. Morpheus can control fire after all. For some more accessories, I made him a wedding bracelet, using epoxy sculpt, paint and nail polish. It's something he and his wife both wear, as sign they love each other. The last item he gets is this necklace. And with this, the creator of the silver and golden cube is done! Oh, Emu.
Don't you
recognize
your friend?
Wow, I'm so happy you could finally make this character. I designed him about, well, 2.5 years ago. Even now I made him, he's still my favorite character. Let's hope he doesn't die again that soon. Like tradition, all the Deus characters will always have their first reveal in the Divas series. And we still have 4 to go. So which one are you excited for? Let me know in the comments. Hey, do you like the content I make? And would you like to see more of these videos on YouTube? Supporting me on Patreon or YouTube membership would really help this channel. In return, you get fun extras, like a lot of exclusive content. But if you can't be a supporter, that's totally okay. A like, a comment, or a recommendation to a friend also really helps this channel. And if you like some merch, I've put some new designs in the store. Links are in the description box. I would like to thank my lovely patrons of honor. Chelsea Panda Monkey, Maddening Dreams, Cat Vanity, Painted by Picasso, Mystery Wolf, Kei Namaru, Jay Natalie, Tiny Viking, 707, and everyone else on Patreon and YouTube memberships. Thank you guys! And thank you for watching! Like always, like if you liked it, and sub if you loved it. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!